Oh, boys and girls, it's Bible time again, and I'm so excited about our lesson today. We're going to find out somebody else that got to see Jesus after he rose from the dead. But let's start with our welcome song, shall we? Welcome to school. It's a wonderful day for working and learning and sharing and play. Bible and reading, arithmetic too, and making new friends, all are fun to do. Boys and girls, let's ask the Lord to help us with our lesson today. Lord, thank you so much for your holy word. The Bible says your word is truth, and we thank you for it. Thank you for the truth of your word. Thank you for the truth that we've learned about how Jesus died on the cross to pay for our sins, that he was buried and rose again 3 days later. Lord, thank you for this wonderful truth from your word. Thank you for my boys and girls. I pray that you keep every one of them healthy as well as their family. Help them to listen, not just with their ears, but with their eyes. Lord, with their hands by being still or singing with me, but most of all with their heart. I pray that this school year, each of my boys and girls would trust you as Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, let's sing a song. And then as we sing a song, we will open our Bible. He is risen, said the angel. He is risen from the dead. Jesus lives now up in heaven. Jesus lives just as he said. Everything that Jesus said he would do, he did, just like the Bible said he would do. How wonderful that is. Let's go ahead and do this song, and then we'll open our Bible. My heart was black with sin until the Savior came in. His precious blood, I know, has washed me white as snow. And in God's word, I'm told, I'll walk the streets of gold to grow in Christ each day. I'll read my Bible and pray. And that doesn't mean our body will grow. It means inside our spirit and our soul. Well, let's open up our Bible and see what we have today, shall we? I open my Bible so carefully. For it's a special book, you see. It tells me of God and his love for me. Oh, boys and girls, I hope you're going to sit and listen so quietly. This is God's precious holy word for us. Well, boys and girls, we've already learned that when it was just the right time, Jesus Christ left heaven. Here's our picture of heaven. He left heaven. He came down to earth to die on the cross to pay for our sins. And he did that, didn't he, boys and girls? The Bible says he was buried. And 3 days later, he rose from the dead, just like he said he would. He did exactly what he told his disciples that he would do. God's word tells us all about it. Remember, boys and girls, we learned that the ladies came to anoint his body, and oh, they were so sad. Look at their faces. Oh, how sad they were. And they, when they were walking towards the tomb, they said, who will roll away that stone so that we can anoint his body? You think we could get the soldiers to do it? Who will do it? Well, let's go back to that picture, boys and girls. Look at the soldiers. Can you see them? There you go. They all fell down as if they were dead men. When the ladies got there, they found that the stone was already rolled away. And the angel said to them, why seek ye the living amongst the dead? He is not here, for he is risen just as he said he would. Go tell the disciples and Peter that he is risen and that he will see them. And so the ladies, oh my goodness, they were so excited. They wanted to go, and they told Peter, and they told John. And the Bible says that Peter and John ran. Let me turn my to the book of John, because it tells us about them. They ran together, and the Bible says that the other disciple outrun Peter. It was John. He ran faster than Peter. He got there, and when he got there, he stooped down and looked inside. He saw the linen clothes lying. I'm reading it to you right out of the Bible, boys and girls. He saw the linen clothes lying. All right, he went in, and the napkin that was up over his head, not lying with the linen clothes, but wrapped together in a place all by itself. Now, that's a special meaning. Yeah, when the men had a supper, and the napkin was folded and set aside, they knew that the dinner was finished. It was finished. that they wouldn't be returning. Well, that napkin being folded and lying by itself told us that Jesus, he was out of that tomb. He wasn't there. He was risen, and he wasn't going to go back in there. Oh, no. The work of our salvation was finished. Everything that had to be done was finished. Well, remember the disciples, they were pretty scary. They were scared. They kind of like the people today. There's so many people today with this COVID-19 virus going around. Oh, some people are just so filled with fear. But the Bible says we don't have to live with fear. We have good news. In fact, the Bible says we could be of good cheer. You know what? That's something, a good study for us to do. Just look in God's word and say, and see where it says, be of good cheer. It is I. Jesus told that to disciples when he walked on the water, when they were out in that boat and there was a storm and they were afraid. They said, oh, they thought it was a ghost. No, he said, no, be of good cheer. It is I. Jesus is right there. We can be of good cheer because this is not taking God by surprise. He is right there with us, boys and girls, and he loves us. And there's nothing that's going to happen to us unless God allows it. Well, the Bible also tells us that Mary Magdalene, who the Lord had freed her from demons that were living inside her, and he had freed her. The Bible says she stood outside the sepulcher. Then the sepulcher, that's a three-syllable word. Sepulcher, that's another name for tomb. She stood outside that sepulcher, and she was weeping. She was weeping. And as she wept, she stooped down, looked inside. She saw the two angels in there, and they said, why weepest thou? She said, because they've taken away my Lord, and I don't know where he is. And when she said that, she turned around, and there was Jesus. But, boys and girls, she did not know that it was Jesus. The last time she had seen Jesus, his face was so beaten and bloody, you couldn't even recognize him as a man. She did not know that this was Jesus. Look, this is his risen body. And so she turned back, and she saw him. All right, but she didn't know it was Jesus. And Jesus said to her, woman, I'm reading it to you right out of the Bible, boys and girls. Woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou? Now, Mary thought he was the gardener. And so she said to him, she said, sir, if you have borne him hence, if you've taken him away, tell me where thou hast laid him. And I will take him away. I'll take care of him. She loved Jesus very much. And all Jesus did then was say her name. He said, Mary. And she turned and looked at him and said, Rabboni, which means master. And she just worshiped him. And he said, touch me not, for I have not yet ascended to my Father. But go tell my brethren and say unto him, I send unto my Father and your Father, and to my God and your God. And Mary ran to the disciples, and she told him that she seen the risen Lord, that he wasn't dead anymore. Now tomorrow, in tomorrow's lessons, boys and girls, we're going to find out two more people that got to see Jesus. And you know, the Bible tells us that Jesus at one time saw 500 people at once. Jesus over and over again showed that he was risen from the dead. Oh, what good news that is. Let's go ahead and sing that song, shall we? Good news, Christ died for me. Good news, if I believe. Good news, I'll live eternally. That's wonderful, extra good news. Alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive, alive forevermore. Alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive. Sing hallelujah, my Jesus is alive forevermore. Sing hallelujah, my Jesus is alive. Isn't that wonderful? It's wonderful, good news. Good news, which is the gospel, that Jesus died on the cross to pay for our sins. We've all sinned and come short of God's glory. But while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. And if we would believe, the Bible says in Romans chapter 10, that if we would believe in our heart that God, well, in fact, let me go ahead and turn there and read it to you, because these are wonderful good news verses. Here we go, boys and girls. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For whosoever, if you believe in him, you're not going to be ashamed of him, are you? Will you? Oh, no. It says, for the scripture saith, whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord, thou shalt be saved. Boys and girls, if you would believe that Jesus Christ, I'm going to hold these up, that crown of thorns that they put on his head, those nails, boys and girls, those nails that they put in his hands and his feet, if you would believe that Jesus Christ died for your sins, that he was buried, boys and girls, in a tomb, and 3 days later, he rose from the dead. If you would believe that, that you're a sinner and you can't save yourself, that Jesus Christ died for your sins, was buried and rose again the third day, and if you'll just call upon his name, the Bible says that you can be saved. And God's word is truth. It doesn't lie. And God's word said you could do that. Boys and girls, today could be the day that you trust Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You've got to believe in your heart that he died for your sins, was buried and rose again the third day. If you believe that and call upon his name, God's word says he would save you. You could do that today. You could pray a simple prayer like this. Lord Jesus, I know I've sinned against you, but Lord, I believe that you died to pay the penalty for my sins. And Lord, I ask that you would forgive my sins right now and come into my heart and save me. I'm calling upon your name, Lord. And your word says if I'll call upon you for salvation, you'd save me. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Thank you, Lord, for making me whole. Thank you, Lord, for giving to me thy great salvation so rich and free. Boys and girls, if you prayed that prayer, you are saved. And how long are you saved? For eternity, forever. The Bible says when you get saved, God puts you in his hand. God the Son covers you, and God the Holy Spirit seals you. You're saved and safe forever. Wow, that's wonderful, extra good news. And boys and girls, if you've done that, if there was a time that you've done that, would you please tell me? Maybe when we FaceTime or when we Zoom, or you could call me or FaceTime me on my phone, you tell me that you've done that, okay? Tell your mommies, tell your daddies, tell your grandmas, tell your grandpas, tell your pastor at your church, tell your Sunday school teacher. That's wonderful good news, and they would be so, so very happy that you've done that. All right, boys and girls, goodbye for today. I love you. Bye-bye now.